The following preview has been approved for all audiences by the Motion Picture Association of WPGA. The film advertised has been rated W for Wolves.
In a cold, dark school in the west side of Vancouver, a gambling plague rules students. However, two teachers must go undercover to expose and destroy the underground gambling ring.
Saturday morning?
Is that Morocco and Spain?
No.
Oh, England and France.
England and France!
Of course, yeah, I'm English.
Of course. Yeah. And England's gonna win, right?
Yeah, I love Pickford too. Really? He's good. He's real good. Alright, let's talk about this.
Okay.
Watch it.
Nice shot, buddy.
Nice shot.
Thank you.
Hey, fellas.
Yeah. Big man needs you. ASAP.
Oh, okay.
Wonder what he wants.
Hi, I've been expecting you two. Since you're both more interested in golf than teaching, I have a special assignment for you. A case that's plaguing the school. Gentlemen, I want you to infiltrate the classes, and I want you to find the organizer.
Wait. What, students?
Infiltrate that class and find the organizer.
Happy on the SS soldier, man. Loyalty over royalty, I know the vibes.
Woke it, tell my side it's a movie. Blue cheese, I swear I'm addicted to blue cheese. I gotta stick to this paper like blue sleep. Bitch, I'm about my chicken like it's a two-piece. You can have your back to your groupie. She just got all my kids in a two-seat. Swagged out, familiar, we bringing them gas out. I still got some racks stuffed in the trap house. Off the 42, I'm blowing her back out. I'm back on my bullshit, spin back with a full clip. They say I'm moving real quick, and my shooters, they shooting. I won't take her, they roof, Chris. I get the breeze, then it's adios. If I'm with your trees, then she give it. Yeah. When I see police, then we gang low. That's another piece, that's another zone. I got all this water on me like Fiji. Smoking the Zaza, it goes straight to the Mata. Then I'm up in the chopper, hitting the cha-cha. Open his lata, then he dancing my chata. Smoking the Zaza, it goes straight to the Mata. Then I'm up in the chopper, hitting the cha-cha. Then I'm open his lata, then he dancing my chata. Whoop it.
To be honest, I don't care.
Come on, you must be a little bit curious.
You know, I heard she was a cop.
Well, I heard she was a prison warden.
Actually, I heard she was the leader of a gang.
What? That's what I heard.
Whatever, I just wish Mr. Pike never left. He was the best.
Ugh, you just liked him because he let you do anything you wanted.
A devious lick.
Oh, okay, carry on.
What's your point?
If I'm ever gonna make it to Stanford, I need discipline.
Sorry, dude. This new principal's just gonna be another washed-up pencil pusher who's only concerned with following every rule in the code of conduct. Meet Morp Z, robot vice principal, engaged.
Is that what you think?
Hey! UVP alert. You must be the new vice principal. I'm grade 12, Austin Yonke.
No, don't let me interrupt. You were describing what kind of person I'm going to be. I'd like you to finish.
It's not necessary. or I could recap really quickly. Let's see, I think I said something about you being a washed up pencil pusher.
Now, do the robot voice.
What?
The robot voice you were doing when you implied I was a rule following robot. I want to hear it again.
Meet more Zarb robot.
That's a terrible robot voice.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, and next time I see you, I want you to be wearing a tie.
Actually, the old VP didn't really care if we wore ties.
Well, the new VP does, and more importantly, she cares that you all follow the uniform guidelines. Hello everyone, I'm your new vice principal, Miss White. Speech! That was my speech.
So when the supply curve moves this way, we have the tax. Now, what does the triangle above the price represent?
Consumer surplus.
That's right, John. Hey, Seb, what does this rectangle of the tax graph represent?
Surplus or something?
Hey, Seb, the ocean called. They're running out of shrimp.
Oh, yeah. That's what I should have said.
The ocean called, they're running out of shrimp?
Yeah. But then I said to him, oh yeah? Well, the jerk store called and they're running out of you.
Really? That's great. You actually said that to him?
Well, I actually thought it up on the way here.
Oh, well, that's not quite the same.
No, it's not. But you don't know this guy. It would have been so sweet.
Could have been.
That's not good.
I gotta find a way to use that zinger on him.
You do realize you need a new audience, right?
What are you talking about?
Well, you can't expect to zing him in front of the same class. You know, the ones that already laughed at his joke.
Yeah, you're right. Oh, I got no other classes with Lou, though.
What happened with Lou?
Okay, so listen to this. Seb was scarfing down shrimp, and then Mr. Lou comes up and says, hey, Seb, the ocean called. They're running out of shrimp.
Oh, that's fire.
Now listen to the comeback.
Oh, yeah? Well, the jerk store called, and they're running out of you.
What's a jerk store?
I don't get it. Why don't you just call him a shrimp?
Yeah. That'll get him.
No! I don't need another line. I got the line. Jerk store's the line.
Wait, Seb, where are you going?
I gotta go find Huggins.
Mr. Huggins, please. I need to get into Lou's stats class.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. It's past the cutoff, and I don't understand why you, of all people, want to get into AP stats.
Hey! You want me to be real with you? Alright. Lou zinged me, and I got this insane comeback. I just need a fresh audience for it.
Wait, what did you say?
I just need a fresh audience?
No, did you say Lou zinged you?
Yeah. It was brutal.
Huggins. Wow, I'm digging the fit.
Where are you going? Big night in the town?
Oh, Maiden's in town. I haven't seen them since 2008. It's going to be an awesome show. All their best hits as well as their new album, too.
Hey, Huggins. The 80s called. They want their fit back.
Loser.
Mr. Huggins? Mr. Huggins?
You start AP Stats next week.
Really? Yes! You will not regret this.
Hey class, I'm sure you all know Seb, who for some awful act of the universe is now joining our class.
Hey guys, happy to be here. Does anyone want some shrimp? Huh? I mean, I brought some for everybody.
Well, Seb, I hope you can catch up in time for the exam coming up.
I don't know, maybe. Hey, let's see how many I can fit in my mouth.
Hey, you know, Seb? The ocean called. They're running out of shrimp.
Oh, yeah? Well, the jerk store called, and they're running out of you.
Well, what's the difference? You're their all-time bestseller.
Loser. No, what, Lou? You're a shrimp.
That's inappropriate, man.
Dude, that's cold.
These are shrimp, so I wasn't in the wrong. Make fun of me first.
Oh, yeah, the innuendo store called. They're running out of appropriate jokes.
Oh, damn. Yeah. That's what I should have said. Duh. Oh.
The arm.
Just hurt my arm.
Oh no, what happened?
It's nothing. Don't worry. I'm fine.
Hey, come on, Taya. I think we got it alone. Guys.
So Parker wouldn't tell us how he hurt his arm, which only means one thing.
He's in an underground boxing league?
No, he heard her doing something embarrassing, like searching up dad jokes. Wait. But how do you hurt yourself searching up dad jokes?
Could be a sports injury. You know, I sprained my wrist playing ping pong last year.
Ping pong?
Yeah, it's a much more violent sport than you think.
Attention, everyone. I can hear you speculating about the nature and the origin of my injury from the staff room. I tripped over an uneven sidewalk. Now get back to class before you're late. Do you want to know how I actually hurt my arm?
Yes.
I was hula hooping, but my son and I attend a weekly class for fitness and fun. I've mastered all the moves. The night dragon, the periwinkle, the spider monkey, and the oopsie doopsie.
Why are you telling me this?
Because no one will ever believe you.
No.
You sick monster!
School year at WPGA is busy. As students struggle with their course load, they often try to find the easy way out. We're here to discover, what lengths would students go for success? Hi, I'm John Quinones. And what...
Hey, how do you connect to the printer here?
And this is what would you do?
Universities are becoming more competitive, and statistics show that cheating has been on the rise over the last few years. So we wondered, what would you do if one of your classmates cheated behind the teacher's back? We set up hidden cameras in an AP Psych class in room 33 at WPGA. The plan is for Mr. Bonin to purposely leave his computer unattended. There, we will see which students decide to cheat, and how their fellow classmates will react. We have planted a few student actors, of course, and they won't waste any time getting started. Let's see how this plays out.
Okay, everybody, so that's it. We're just gonna get ready to get started now. So put away your phones and other gadgets, and we'll get this going.
Ella, that's for you. Riley, here you go. Good luck. Fleur, for you. Taya, Austin, here you are. Good luck. Everybody else is okay.
Hope School. There are hot cookies down in the dining hall. Get down and get those cookies while they're fresh.
Okay, everybody, looks like I forgot something in my office which I have to go and get, so mind your own papers while I'm gone, and I'll be right back.
I am not ready for this test.
Me neither.
Now the action begins. In no time at all, this student takes advantage of Mr. Bonin's absence.
Hey, you find the answer key yet?
Give me a sec, there's like a million files here.
It's crazy.
Seriously, right in here?
And he's going up and he's taking the test and he's opening the laptop. Wow.
I can't
believe. Crazy. Right up, and he's cheating.
This is embarrassing.
That's Fleur.
What
wow.
the hell? What's she doing?
Ridiculous.
Right now?
Hurry up, you can be back any minute.
Bingo. You shouldn't be cheating. Why do you care? Bonin's not in class. You're not learning anything. You're only cheating yourself. Whatever, loser. I'm not gonna risk failing another test just for morals. You could fail. You could get expelled. What if your parents find out? You could die. What are you even talking about? How would I die? That was right. This is wrong. You guys should really think about what you're doing. This has nothing to do with you. Go sit down. It does now. You're being selfish. We could all get in trouble. This is so lame. Why do you even care? Give me the laptop.
It's time.
Boom! I'm John Quinones! Out of the way! John Quinones, what would you do?
Move out of the way, John Quinones of the TV show. What would you do? Move out of the way, John Quinones.
The laptop. What are you doing? Taking the computer. You shouldn't be cheating. Why do you care, suck up?
Whoa. Hold on a minute.
Calm down. I'm John Quinones with the TV show. What would you do?
What would you do?
This is our actor, Fleur. Part of our social experiment.
You're an
I'm
actor.
Sorry, I was an act.
You were amazing. Guys, I'm so surprised. They didn't think I'd be on TV today.
Turns out Riley is a real goody two-shoes. Since she first arrived in the school in grade one, she's been working hard and putting in the effort in every single class she has taken. She might not have the best grades, but she certainly tries her best. She truly lives by the code of conduct.
Hi, I'm John Quinones with the TV show. What would you do? Now, Riley, that difficult situation, you chose to do the right thing, even when you could have said nothing or even cheated. Why is that?
Well, sorry, I wasn't planning on getting emotional. I just think that a lot of kids don't even, I just think that, especially going to private school like we do, kids that cheat, I mean, they're just cheating themselves. Like, how are they, I'm so sorry. Sorry, I promise I don't usually cry, but I just saw Fleur. She is such an amazing actor, and she really convinced me she was cheating. And I thought, if she can go cheat, how do I know no one else is cheating? And I was trying to stand up for the kids like me, who even if they don't do great, they have their pride, because they didn't cheat.
We'll be back after the commercial break.
Do you want a way to spice up your uniform? Do you ever get cold in class, since you're not allowed to wear outdoor wear? We have just the products for you. Introducing the Grad Jacket, a luxurious navy blue and white varsity jacket with custom embroidered patches. Just for the low, low price of your entire life savings. Another option is the Grad Cardigan. It is a black polyester blend with custom embroidered names. It keeps you at the perfect temperature while you're sitting in class. Order a cardigan today. It should arrive June 2028. Call 1-800-274-4125. That's 1-800-274-4125. One more time, that's 1-800-274-4125. If you order today, you will get express 6-month shipping. Call now, that's 1-800-274-4125. Buy now!
Hi, I'm John Quinones with the TV show. What would you do? Thanks for joining us this week. Next time, tensions are running high as the senior school film team struggles to finish the term end on time. Will they try to find the easy way out? Join us next time on What Would You Do? Don't provoke, get your teeth smoked.
I'm here. Okay. You can start the meeting now.
The meeting is over. You're late.
You missed roll call and the tutorial on the new WolfNet feature. 3 years and I still can't get you to understand the importance of being on time.
Maybe you should just give up and accept me for who I am?
No, I will break you right now. While you were out being tardy, I was hard at work crafting a special punishment. I've crafted an intricate, personal high five with everyone else in the room except for you.
What? But you hate high fives.
Every minute of it was hell, but it's going to be worse for you. Class dismissed. Goodbye, Hanami.
Saloon to a fannywaggle?
Goodbye, Zhang.
Not the snake charmer.
Goodbye, Sam.
That's a bump bump.
Bye, Sahil.
Double fist bump reverse explosion to a Pete Thompson strum? All right, that was horrible, but at least I'm through it.
Goodbye, Karen from the UCC.
What? No. The lady from the UCC?
Why are we here, Sahil?
I try to take one test, and I almost have to die for it?
Alright, slow down, Sahil. Go back to the beginning.
The beginning?
Yes, the beginning.
Fine. It started as any other day, except there was a catch.
Wait, what's this?
It's the big midterm. Did you study?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, team. Get out your pencils. You may start.
That you're using.
Hey, no talking. You both get zeros and an email home and detentions. I'm sure if you read the question, you'll find your answer.
That's all I'm saying.
No, you may not use the washroom.
I need a pencil.
It's always you. I mean, how many times do I have to tell you? I mean, Sahil, you're not a child anymore.
So, why didn't you ask someone else for a pencil?
I did, but no one wanted to give me one. So I went into the hallway to start asking for pencils. Hey, you got a pencil I could borrow? How about you got a pencil?
Not for you. Yo, pencil. Pencil. Yo, you need a pencil?
Yeah.
Second floor, washroom. Keep it on the level.
Dealing in the washroom? That sounds like a serious offense.
No, that's besides the point. Okay, so I walk into the washroom.
Excuse me? I was told that you sell pencils.
Excuse me, sir?
2 for a stick, 10 for a pack.
I'll take a stick, please. Do you, by chance, take Apple Pay?
What the?
Okay, just take the pencil back, or I don't want any trouble.
What am I supposed to do with this? I can't sell a used pencil.
Really think I was gonna hit you? How do you think I look at my transcript? I won't be able to get into Harvard.
Oh my god. I was so scared. I thought I was about to die.
I would never. My boss, on the other hand? He'd mess you up. If I were you.
Okay.
Yeah, like I know Messi's 5'6", but he's like definitely the GOAT. Like
Ronaldo's 6'2", tanned and abs.
Bro, yeah, did you hear that? What was that?
You got no pants on.
What?
Uniform slip.
So you found a pencil. You can write the test.
Not exactly.
You're mine. Yes, you are. You're mine. And I need you so. You're mine. Never will I let you go.
That's the right answer. Ooh, that's a pretty drawing. Well, good luck finding a job.
And he wouldn't let me retake it.
Why not?
Look, I don't know. He asked if I had extra time or something. Look, all I needed was a pencil. A stupid little pencil.
Honestly, Sahil, it sounds like you need to be a bit better prepared. Sounds like you should use this as a learning opportunity.
You gotta be kidding me. Be more prepared? Yeah, I'll be more prepared. Yeah, I'll show you how to be prepared. I'll show you how to do it. I'll take this. I'll take this too. Be prepared.
Yes, a strange, strange game. Strange, strange.